All right, Bio Labatch, right here, come out. Sit these moguls. What? Just come out the bottom. Come out here, bud.
Now watch this.
Nice. All right. All right, ready? Go to ski down to that pole and wait for me. Yeah, let me look at me. Cameron.
Now.
There you go. Okay, go down to that pole. All right.
All right, you want to see me?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm watching. I have the camera. Go to the pole and stop. Pulls out. There you go. Good. How did that look?
Like a professional.
You see the last few turns I made there? I was like,
yeah. The thing that really makes it look really good is the way you keep your tail so close together.
The tails or the skis?
The skis, and just in general.
How are the knees though? Knee action's good?
Yeah, and you keep your skis super close together, almost like they're one ski.
It's a uni ski. Why?
Because you can ski really well.
Colton, you're going to be so much better than me. The key is on this is to feel what I've learned. Two things is try to feel like your feet on the ground, almost like you're deliberately trying to push your skis, snake them over the snow. Like, so as your feet come over, you point your toes down them. As they come up, you pull your feet, your heels back.
Well?
Yeah. And then be ready to slide into the mogul. So watch. I go here, here. There it is. Nice. I like that turn there.
Hi.
I like that turn there.
What?
It was a good last turn there. See how flexible she is?
What?
To be that flexible again. You okay? Keep going?
Yeah.
We gotta cut over somehow.
What?
We gotta like cut over. We'll have to traverse from the top. Trying to see how the heck we get over to the other side. Hold on a second.
What?
I don't know how to get over to the other side.
Yeah. I can't hear you.
Hold on.
Come on, guys.
Yeah. All right, let's go. You'll lose.
1, 2, 3, go.
Because I'm heavier. Things. One, when you spread out, you definitely want to get squatted down. Your poles are up in the air. You want your like knees to be parallel with the ground, so your body has to be lower. And two, I kind of roll my knees in a little bit to put as little friction on the snow as possible. So you don't want the whole flat of the ski. I mean, sometimes you can. I guess if it's really waxed, it's better. I don't know if that's the.
What did I do wrong?
I'm not doing anything wrong. All right, let's try Cathedral Brook. Once we do that one, then we can go on the other side. Then we'll have done everything over here. Great mountain. Thank you. It was looking pretty thin. There was a like reason to believe that it was going to close and everything, and they consolidated. Between Gore here and Hunter, I think, are all part of the same mountain now. So I don't know if they're closing anything. Cathedral Brook, though, but you know, like in the, as I was saying, like, you know, in a deeper winter, or I'm sorry, when it's, maybe it gets like, you know, we're lucky right now because it's 100% open because there's been a lot of snow and it's been cold. It hasn't really, we haven't gotten any rain. Yeah, that starts to shit. That's why racing is good for you, because racing is, you know, you're kind of always skiing on